Good morning, Prairie Curious Hawks. I'm Thomas from Miss Nuttall's class.
And I'm Oliver, also from Miss Nuttall's class.
And welcome to this week's edition of WPTE. What an amazing week we've had.
I'm so sad that Mr. Botisha is leaving, but on the bright side, spring break is coming, and we had a great visit from author Matt Tavares.
He was so nice. Hey, you want to hear a joke?
Sure, I love jokes.
How do you measure a snake?
I don't know.
In inches, they don't have feet. All that laughing is making me hungry. What's for lunch today?
Today's hot lunch is chicken smackers and dinner roll. The salad is popcorn chicken salad, and the side is mashed potatoes and gravy.
Mmm, sounds so good. Oliver, anyone celebrating a birthday at Prairie Curious today?
Yes, today's birthday is Christopher Rood, also known as Topher, and happy late birthday to Miss Brown. Her birthday was yesterday. Hope your birthday was good.
Happy birthday. Go down to the office to claim your birthday treat when your teacher gives you permission.
Next up is Mary with the weather. What can we expect this weekend?
Hello, Prairie Curious Hawks. I'm Mary Lahequin from Miss Leatherman's class, and welcome to this edition of Weather. Today is a low of 40 degrees and the high is 66, and a 30% chance of rain. Looks like you're going to need a shirt and maybe an umbrella. Looks like it's going to be a groggy day outside. On Saturday, the weather is going to warm up. The low will be 51 and the high is 67 degrees and cloudy skies. I guess we're not going to see much sun for our first day of spring break. On Sunday, it's more of the same. The low will be 44 degrees and the high will be 59 degrees. Rain, rain, go away, come again another day. Looks like it's gonna be a 63% chance of rain. Looks like you're gonna need an umbrella and a raincoat. Looks like you're going to have lots of time to do some reading inside. I know I will. Hope it'll be time to play outside for our spring break. Now back to the studio with Thomas and Oliver.
Thanks, Mary. It looks like it might rain.
Next up, we have Andrew with sports.
Andrew, take it away.
Hi, my name is Andrew, and I'm here from Miss Davis' class, and I'm here with sports. This week's Carmel sports. This weekend, Carmel Junior Varsity Boys Volleyball plays at Chittard on Saturday at 9 a.m. Varsity plays at 10:30 a.m. also at Chittard. But most Carmel teams are off and enjoying their spring break and their week off. All of our Indiana colleges are starting spring sports like baseball, softball, and more. Tune in each week to hear about some of the highlights. Purdue did exactly what most people expected. Beat both teams they played in the opening weekend of March Madness. They beat Grambling 78-50 last Friday and then beat Utah State on Sunday with a final score of 106-67. So now Purdue will play in the Sweet 16 round in the men's tournament. They play tonight against Gonzaga. Tip-off is at 7:39 p.m. If they win, they will play later this weekend in the Elite Eight. The other Indiana team in March Madness is IU women's team. They will also be competing in the Sweet 16 round this weekend. They finished off the last weekend with an exciting win over Oklahoma. This is their third time in 4 years the Hoosiers have reached the Sweet 16. They will now play South Carolina tonight at 5 p.m. This will be a big test for the Hoosiers as they face what many believe are one of the favorites to win the championship. Can the Hoosiers pull off the upset? This weekend also kicks off the Hockey National Championship Tournament. While no Indiana teams are in the tournament this year, this is a great opportunity to watch some amazing hockey. The action starts this weekend and will conclude on April 13th. Indiana Pacers play tonight at 7 p.m. against the Lakers. The Pacers last week got their spot in the NBA playoffs as a 6 seed, and they will be facing the Cavaliers as the 3 seed. And that's all for sports. Now back to the studio with Oliver and Thomas.
Good luck to all our Indiana teams.
is up next with National Days. Let's see what National Days we could celebrate today.
Hello, Prairie Trace Hawks. This is Delaney from Mrs. Van Dam's class here with National Days. Today is National Mirrors Day. Thank goodness for the invention of mirrors. Saturday is National Take a Walk to the Park Day. I'll be sure to take a walk and get some exercise. And Sunday is Easter. I'll be sure to eat lots of candy. Thanks for watching this edition of National Days. Now back to the studio with Thomas and Oliver.
Thank you, Delaney.
Now we have Will and Paxton with Did You Know?
Will and Paxton, take it away.
Hi, I'm Paxton from Miss Van Dam's class.
And I'm Will, also from Miss Van Dam's class.
And this is this week's edition of Did You Know?
Did you know that Brett Favre was drafted the Falcons and the Falcons coach hated him?
No, I didn't. But did you know that a crocodile can't stick its tongue out?
Wow, no, that's crazy. But did you know that ketchup was once sold as a medicine?
I did not. But did you know that a cat has 32 muscles in each ear?
No, but did you know that a hippo's jaw opens wide enough to fit a sports car inside?
That's crazy. But did you know that it's time to go back to the studio?
No, I didn't, but now I do.
Now back to the studio with Oliver and Thomas.
Wow, I did not know those facts.
Hey, Thomas, do you like pets?
You know me, of course I do.
Well, next up we have Irene with Pets on the Prairie.
Hi, Prairie Chase Hawks. This is Irene from Miss Van Dam's class here with Pets on the Prairie. I'm with Miss Waller and her dog. Hi, Miss Waller.
Hello.
What's your dog's name and breed?
She's what we call a double doodle. She's a, her dad's a labradoodle, and her mother's a golden doodle.
What's your dog's name?
And her name is Dolly Madison. Most dogs have one name, but we named her Dolly Madison because she was born on July 4. And Miss Madison was the first lady.
She'll be 10 years old this July 4th.
Does Dolly Madison do any tricks?
Oh, she does.
What?
She does tricks.
Oh,
because
yeah. I taught her to play basketball once, to give her a ball and drop it in the bucket. And for a long time after that, she would pick up a toy and drop it in a wastebasket. So I'd always have to watch, make sure I didn't throw away a toy.
She also would find tennis balls and put them in the dishwasher if we weren't watching. Just any container.
Is there any funny stories about Dolly Madison?
Oh, lots of funny stories. Unfortunately, she's too smart sometimes and can... We have most of our door, our lever doors, you know. Mm-hmm. And she opens the doors when she's not supposed to.
What's your favorite part about owning Dolly Madison?
Oh, lots of things. She's she's a snuggler. Our favorite part about having a dog.
She's a real snuggler.
And she has a lot of dog toys that she likes to take out in the yard and and then not bring them back.
Dolly, you want to sit? Can you sit?
What's Dolly Madison's favorite type of treat?
Oh, just...
Here's one of her favorite treats. This is Oh, boy.
She likes about any kind of treat.
That's all for now. Thank you, Ms. Waller, for coming here.
And I just want to say thanks to granddaughter Paige for helping get the pictures together of her.
Now back to the studio with Thomas and Oliver. Who let the dogs out?
Was nice, the party was pumping. Thank you. And everybody having a ball. Until the fellas started in calling. And the girls respond to the call. I have a pull my shout out. Who let the dogs out? 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 I see the dance. Billy Pongers, get out. Get back, Gruffy. Bash, Gruffy. Get back, you flea infested mongrel. Gonna tell myself I'm man, no get angry. Hey, yeah. Two Eddie cows calling them canine. Hey, but they tell me, hey man, start up the party. You put a woman in front and a man behind. I have a woman shout out. Who let the dogs out?
Thanks, Miss Waller.
Your pet is so cute.
Well, now we have Vivian with current events.
Vivian, take it away.
Hi, PT Hawks. I'm Vivian from Miss Leatherman's class, and welcome to this week's current events. A penumbral lunar eclipse took place on Monday, March 25th, 2024. It was visible to the naked eye, as 95.57% of the moon was immersed in Earth's penumbral shadow, making it the deepest penumbral lunar eclipse overall since May 5th, 2023. You probably wouldn't even know it was happening unless you looked really close. Also, scientists had discovered solar panels can give more electricity to the body. These solar panels can also protect the water it's sitting on. Also, the solar panels do not only protect water forms, they can even protect land forms too. Finally, scientists believe that hydrogen is told to help regulate the climate and still produces a lot of energy. Hydrogen will be playing a big role to stop climate change, but unfortunately, hydrogen created pollution instead of helping climate change. Scientists discovered this. They think there might be hydrogen piles underground. Thanks for watching. Now back to the studio, Thomas and Oliver.
I did not know these things were happening in the world.
Same here, buddy. But next up, we have vocab with word of the week with Florencia.
Florencia, take it away.
This week's word is tend. It means to take care or look after something or someone. Synonyms are nurture, care. Let's play a game. I'll use the word in a sentence. If I use it correctly, give your neighbor a high five. If I use it incorrectly, give me a thumbs down. Ready? Okay. Sentence 1. I tend to my puppy by giving him water and food and taking him for walks. I hope you gave your neighbor a high five because that was right. Sentence 2. I tend to my friend when they are hurt by ignoring them and walking away. I hope you have a thumbs down. That was not the right use of tend. All right, last sentence. I tend to my garden by watering my plants, getting rid of weeds, and making sure they are planted in good soil. I hope you gave someone a high five. Well, that's all for Word of the Week. Think about how you can tend to a loved one over spring break. Now back to the studio.
I will make sure to start using the word tend more often in my vocab.
Same here, dog. Well, now we have Penelope with Person of the Week.
Penelope, take it away.
Hi, I'm Penelope from Mrs. Davis's class, here with Person of the Week. This week's person is Ada Lovelace. Here's a little information about her. Ada Lovelace was born on December 10, 1815 in England. Even though she was the daughter of a famous poet, she liked math and science more. She's most famous for writing lots of books and articles on mathematics and science. But she's most famous for being the first person to have a job as a computer programmer. Sadly, she died on November 27, 1852. That's all for Person of the Week. Now back to the studio with Thomas and Oliver.
Wow, Ada Lovelace is definitely an important person.
Yeah, but now we have Florencia with leadership.
Florencia, take it away.
Hi, I'm Florencia from Mrs. Davis's class and here for the leadership skill. April's leadership skill is collaboration. It means working together to complete a task. Here are some examples of using collaboration. My friend Maggie Switzer said, we have to use collaboration when working on a science activity. My other friend Ellie Thalberg said, I use collaboration when we figured out what to play. And lastly, my friend Sadie said, we use collaboration to work on building our robot. Throughout the month of April, try to work on collaborating with others in a productive way. When we collaborate, we work as a team. That's all for leadership, this week's leadership skill. Now back to Thomas and Oliver in the studio.
Hey Oliver, it's been so fun getting to collaborate with you on this anchor script this week.
Yeah, same here, Shark, but now we have Vivian with Teacher Feature.
Vivian, take it away.
Hi, PT Hawks. This is Vivian from Miss Leatherman's class, here with Teacher Feature, and this is Miss Lehi Koinen. Okay, let's start. What is your favorite place to eat, and what do you order?
Ooh, that's a good question. My favorite place to eat is probably a place that's not even here in Indiana. So I like to go to Cafe Rio when I'm in California or Utah, which is where I went to school, and I order the smothered burrito. It is quite delicious.
That sounds really good. Question number 2. What is your favorite place in the house and why?
My bedroom, because then I get to sleep in my bed.
Question number 3. Who do you think is going to win the NCAA men's basketball tournament?
Well, my college team is no longer in it, so I'm kind of rooting for Purdue. That's who I want to win the whole thing.
Same. Question number 4. What is your favorite song?
My favorite song, let's see, I think I would say At Last. It's a song that I sang at my wedding, and I sang it when I was in high school, and so It's just one of my favorites.
That's really cool. Final question. If you didn't work at Prairie Trace, what would you do?
Ooh, that is a good question. So before I became a mom and stayed at home with my kids for a while, I worked in a communications department where I helped them with events. So I was an event coordinator and I got to travel all over the United States and especially Hawaii. And I really, really loved it, and it was really, really hard to leave it, but I had two little babies and I couldn't really travel far anymore. So if I didn't have kids and I wasn't working at Prairie Trace, that's what I would love to go back and do.
That's really cool. Thank you, Ms. Lahikoinen, for joining us. Now back to the studio with Thomas and Oliver.
Thank you, Vivian and Mrs. L.
Thomas, do you like puzzles?
I love puzzles as much as I love pets. Why?
Because next up we have Neil with this week's SC puzzle.
Neil, take it away.
Hello, everyone. This is Neil, and welcome to this week's SC puzzle. These are the rules. First, you make your original guess. After that, the screen will show five clues one at a time. Each time a clue appears, it'll tell you something to help you change your guess to the right number. Each time a clue is said, make sure that your guess makes sense. The answer is lesson 100, and it is part of this pattern. 7, 13, 19, 25. The answer does not include the digit 6. The answer includes the digit 7. The answer is not equal to 146 halves. The answer is not equal to 194 halves. Everyone, make your final guesses. And the answer is 37. That was fun. Now back to the studio with Thomas and Oliver.
Wow, that was hard. Thanks, Neil.
I'm Oliver.
And I'm Thomas, and thanks for tuning in.
We will end with the national anthem, leadership pledge, and a moment of silence. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you on the prairie.
I pledge as a Prairie Trace Elementary leader to have a positive attitude each day. I will make good choices even when no one is looking. I will demonstrate leadership skills to make myself and my school an amazing place.